We need to go through all this, huh?
Yep.
Okay, now is the time to check your cell phones and turn them off. The thought for the day is Mrs. Harding.
Let's base all of our decisions on what is in the best interest of the students.
Thank you. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Let the record reflect that all board members are present, with the exception of Mr. Altman and Mrs. Crumley, who are excused. Could we please take a moment of silence for personal reflection? Thank you. Attorney Alfonso, public comment.
I can report for the record there are no green cards, so I will spare you the script.
Okay, we have one miscellaneous action item, and I need a motion to approve.
Get a motion, then I just need to explain what we're doing.
Okay. I'll make a motion to approve the out-of-state travel to New York for the ratings presentation for the issuance of COPS Series 2020A and the refunding of COPS Series 2005B1 and Series 2014A.
Second.
Thank you. Motion by Armstrong, second by Harding. Mr. Browning.
Madam Chairman, just so you'll know that Mr. Gadd will not be traveling. We didn't think it was wise that both he and I were out of town at the same time. So it would be the chair, the superintendent, Ms. Swenson, and Mr. Cristofaro, the director of finance. Law requires us to approve travel. So that's the reason we're meeting. I apologize for the short notice. We did notice the meeting in the Tampa Bay Times, I believe. Yes, we did. Let the record reflect. So all the public notification's been done. I just wanted to know that the purpose was to go up there and make the presentation to the rating agencies like we've done in the past. That being said, and Ms. Swenson can fill in, it is still a little questionable whether or not we will go in light of the travel restrictions and the viruses and what have you. So.
Yeah, and I'm in communications with our finance advisor. The market, obviously, you know what's going on. Mm-hmm. We will still go to the rating agency presentation. However, the travel to New York would depend on what happens in New York. If you heard yesterday, yes. They were closing a lot. However, we will still have to do the ratings presentation. We might delay the selling of the bonds because we were scheduled to have all this done by May. That's why the reason you haven't seen anything, because we won't be working behind the scenes to see if the numbers were there. And they were there 2 weeks ago, or a week ago, when we were running the numbers. We still think there will be the numbers, but we just don't know what, when, and how. So all that information will come to you in the next board meeting, all the resolutions and all the documentation attached to the resolutions.
Okay, thank you. Do we need to modify the motion to so it's not referring to a particular date as it is?
No, because if you're just...
Because it does say a date, event date, March 25th.
If you want to go ahead and just remove the date subject to travel restrictions... Yeah. That would be fine. Would that be okay, Councilor?
Yes, it would. In fact, that's an excellent suggestion. The point of the whole motion and this whole special meeting is the board simply has to make a finding that the trip is serving an educational purpose, and that's really what you have done, in fact. So the date, I think if you do that and say that it's related to the date, would be fine, conditional on the date.
Does it also have to do with a school board member traveling out of district?
If it's, you have to make the finding that it's for an educational purpose.
Okay,
which would do it. All right. So I would like to add to my motion the addendum that the date is to be determined.
So we need a second.
Second.
On the addendum.
Second on
any
the addendum.
Discussion? So we need to approve the addendum. So
right.
We need to vote to approve the amendment. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. And now we need any other discussion on the travel? So now we need to vote for approval of the travel. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries.
Madam Chairman, before we get out of here, just real quickly, I wanted to update you, and we will get something out to board members, but it is an ever-changing landscape about the COVID-19 virus. I've had more conference calls over the last 3 days than I think I have since I've been superintendent. We had a conference call last week with the governor and Surgeon General, Lieutenant Governor, Commissioner Corcoran. There was a conflicting memo or advisory that came out of the Department of Health yesterday about international travel and cruises. They said you have to self-quarantine 14 days, and they retracted that one very quickly. They're following CDC guidance, which is if you go to one of those five impacted countries that are black on the CDC map, you need to self-quarantine or be quarantined for 14 days. If you have cruise travel or international travel in countries that are not on the list, then if you exhibit symptoms, then they are strongly recommending that you self-quarantine for at least the 14 days. We're communicating with district staff. We've been communicating. We've actually changed the website now, so instead of being one of the bars on the website, it's in the green bubble, and it says coronavirus. So we had people, even district staff, that was having a difficult time seeing the button. So we've changed all that. The memos are out there. The videos are out there. We'll be doing probably one more video, and then we'll have some in the bank. So over spring break, if something changes, we will at least have a message that will fit what's happened, and staff will post that out over spring break to the website. So we're continuing to clean buses. We're continuing to clean classrooms. We're encouraging the washing of hands, sneezing in the elbow. We're taking all the precautions that we've been advised to take. So no reported cases in Pasco at this point, but we will keep the board informed.
Thank you.
Can I add to that? But in case you hear about kids traveling, we have kids traveling.
That's true.
So we have kids going to DC, different kinds of opportunities all over the place. That's fluid, could change. You know, we had one high school that was going to Italy. They're not going to Italy now. They're going to Ireland. But if you hear about kids traveling, they are traveling. You know, international Odyssey of the Mind, I don't think it's impacting our kids. It's impacting some charter schools, is in London, I think in the next 2 or 3 days. So people are traveling. They will be going unless something changes.
And there's another conference call this morning at 11 o'clock with the Commissioner of Education to update us one more time on anything changed. There was a big press conference with the governor yesterday. And then I'm scheduling another conference call late this afternoon with superintendents statewide to talk about making sure that all districts are as uniform as we possibly can be when it comes to taking the necessary steps to make sure schools are clean, buses are clean, kids are staying safe, and we're communicating out with parents what the facts are. Trying to allay all the hype and the panic, but I think we're a little too late for that. So that's all I have on that. I just want to make sure that I told the board while I had you together.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Anybody else have anything? Okay, I need a motion to adjourn.
Meeting adjourned.
Thank you.